Hey everyone, Clara here. If you've been invited to a Figma or FigJam file and aren't sure what to do or where to start, hopefully this video can get you up and running and comfortable navigating those files. First up, in a Figma design file, content is often organized by pages. If the page panel is collapsed, you'll want to expand it by clicking this portion in the panel on the left. Once it's open, you can now see all of the other pages and you'll be able to click through them to view its content. You can scroll around with your trackpad or mouse, but there are quite a few ways to have more control of what you're seeing. If you prefer to view things screen by screen, you can always use the hotkey N. This will cycle you through every frame on the canvas in a top-down, left-to-right order. Shift N will take you to the previous frame. Holding FN while using the left and right arrow keys will have the same effect. If you prefer to pan across the canvas, holding down the spacebar will allow you to click and move around. To zoom, you have a few options. Command plus and minus work as expected. You can also hold Z and click to zoom in more. And my personal favorite is to hold Z while clicking to make a specific selection. After you drag to your desired viewport, it will take you there when you let go. If you ever want to reset the entire view to see all of the frames on the page, you can hit Shift 1. Or maybe you've already selected the exact frame you want. You can use Shift 2 to take you to that frame. Now, if the design also has a prototype associated with it, you're able to click this play icon to interact with it. But if you want the specs for the interactions, you can use Shift E to reveal them or click this visibility icon in the flow section. Shift E will also toggle the interactions on and off. Aside from the prototype and end shortcuts, all of these will also work in FigJam. If you ever want to review any of these shortcuts, you can always access the shortcuts panel by clicking this question mark icon at the bottom right and going to keyboard shortcuts, or by using the shortcut Control Shift question mark. Hope this helps. See you next time.